Aloha, it's Brandon. I want to take you along with me on my flight today from Honolulu to Kona on Hawaiian Airlines. I was on flight number 178 out of gate 19 in Terminal 1. There's some construction going on in the terminal check-in area, so I headed all the way down to the end on the left. This area is where Hawaiian Airlines usually checks in their international South Pacific flights. Since I had used the mobile app for check-in and already had my boarding pass without the need to check any luggage, I just headed all the way down to security. I breezed through the short TSA pre-check line. I recommend you get pre-check even if you only fly a couple of times a year. It's good for 5 years and you can renew online, which is really nice. Once through security, I headed up to the Plumeria lounge, which you can access if you are a priority pass member and have an outbound ticket. Of course, when I went up, it was 6:10 in the morning and it was still closed. One thing to note about this Plumeria lounge is nowhere on the Hawaiian Airlines website does it say you can access this lounge with priority pass. It's not till you actually get and arrive at the club that you will see these signs for priority pass members. Other than that, you need to go to the priority pass website. This lounge is usually reserved for international first class type passengers. The morning spread is kind of basic. Don't skip the taro and sweet potato chips. Got some hard-boiled eggs, some cheese, and if the time zone is right for you, they do have some Maui Brewing Company beer available. A basic, simple, but quite nice lounge, the Hawaiian Plumeria Lounge. So heading down to my gate, I of course was a little bummed to see that my gate was 19. This means that I'd be flying out of the older terminal and not the newer one. You can tell you're in the older terminal when the flight information displays look like this with the wood all around it versus these new ones. Gates A1 through 12 are in the new terminal that's completely enclosed and air conditioned. A13 through 20 are still Terminal 1, but in the older section of the terminal. I was on the workhorse Boeing 717 on my flight from Honolulu to Kona today, and it's named Elepaio, which is an endemic to Hawaii bird. The Boeing 717s in Hawaiian's fleet are named after local birds. The Airbus A330s bear the name of a star or constellation, and the Airbus A321neos are named after native plants and forests. If you don't see the name on the outside near the nose of the plane, it will be on the placard right when you enter. Boeing 717s are a workhorse for Hawaiian and have done the job quite well over the years. As the fleet ages, there is discussion about what planes will take their place sometime in 2025 or 2026. The Airbus A220 and the Embraer E2 are at the top of the list. We shall see. Let me know in the comments which one you would prefer to take the place of the Boeing 717s. After settling in and pulling back from the gate, we headed down to the reef runway. It was a beautiful, clear day. Let's enjoy the takeoff through the cloud line.
call your attention to the no smoking and fasten seatbelt signs. Again, smoking, including the use of any electronic smoking device, is not permitted at any time. If the captain turns off the fasten seatbelt sign, that means you can get up if you need to. But we recommend you keep your seatbelt fastened whenever you're seated in case of unexpected turbulence. And one final reminder, please make sure you've put all your electronic devices in airplane mode and turned off their transmittal capabilities. Mahalo nui moa.
You can see right in the middle of your screen, there's Hanama Bay, Koko Crater, and Makapuku Lighthouse. Let me zoom in a little bit so you can get a little close up. It's a gorgeous day, and the light in the morning hit those mountains just perfectly. On cue, the passion orange guava was served. I hope they never change this. And yes, I was able to open this container without a splash. We ended up passing over Molokai, then Lanai, then Maui, where we can see the majestic Haleakala. It was about this time that the descent into Kona started, and the pilot said we were expecting some turbulence, so we shall see. Here's a quick shot of the south side of Maui. It was a clear day in Kona, if only my window had less water spots. Oh well. So it was a pretty hard touchdown in Kona, but that meant my favorite part of the whole trip was just coming up. The one thing I love about Kona is you get to exit on these open ramps and not an enclosed jetway. Because there's very little rainfall in this area, it just works great for Kona, and it's just a great experience, great way to end your trip if you're getting here, or to start your trip if you're visiting the Big Island. I enjoyed sharing this trip with you guys. If I don't see you in a terminal, I'll see you in the lobby.